Good morning. Good morning. And welcome. So glad that God's brought us together this morning for this opportunity to worship. We have our bell folks here today, ringers, going to ring for us under Jane's direction, able director. Thank you, Jane. And they're going to ring twice, I think, at the beginning and in the middle. So thankful for that. Glad that they're able to be here to do that for us. A few announcements to bring to your attention this morning. First off, Carla. Where are you, Carla? You want to stand up, exercise that knee? Yeah, exercise that hip? Just to show us you can. Yay! All right. So it also happens to be Carla and Jan's 61st, right? Wedding anniversary today. Yeah. Welcome. Congratulations. Anybody else having a momentous occasion today, a birthday or an anniversary? Who? Oh, this is the 11th anniversary of my installation here at CTL. I installed on the 11th. And who else? Yeah, thank you. Yeah. What else?
You forgot to announce I was a child bride.
You were a child bride, yes. We totally understand that. Yeah. Yeah, okay. All right. So we have another part of our announcement today is God's Work Our Hands Sunday. I'm going to say a little more about that in a little bit, but all the stuff in the center aisle is here so that we can actually do service in the midst of worship today. We don't do this really often, but the ELCA sets aside one Sunday a year when we acknowledge that we are a serving community. It's what we do. It's how we're called together as disciples to be in service to one another. And so we're going to actually physically do something today. So we're going to get some instruction on that as we get to that point of service and invite you to be a part of that. But our mission is, God's work, our hands are busy in lots of places. What's in your announcement, your Wednesday announcements this week. We've been gathering money in the hunger jar. We gathered about $300 in the hunger jar that has come to us. On Saturday, September 24th, at 9 a.m. to noon at Highlands Church, which is near Pinnacle Peak. It's Pinnacle Peak and Pima. You turn to the east off of Pima on Pinnacle Peak, and Highlands Church is back there. They've registered for 5 to 10, but we can make room for more, and I'm sure Deb Slack, Wade, Deb will be organizing that. Anybody who would like to go to help packing that day, another great service project. Great service project. So we'll be doing that on that day. We're visiting our partners in the Denza Village. We celebrate our partners. These baskets that are always on the altar. These three baskets were gifts to us 12 years ago when we began our partnership with the parish in Denza Village. We keep them there to remind us to pray for them. They pray for us on a regular basis. Prayer is the first pillar of three pillars of service. Projects are another. Every year we make a contribution to some project that they're working on in the parish. We have bought beehives and motorcycles and fruit trees, and we have installed roofs on the sanctuary, and we've bought bricks, and we've put solar panels in, and we've dug wells. It's amazing what we've been able to do over the last 11 years in Denza Village to improve the quality of life in that community and in that parish. So the third pillar is presence. So prayer, projects, and presence. So about every 3 or 4 years, we try to go over there and visit the parish and talk to their partnership committee and look at the projects that have been done and do all that. We're going on October the 3rd. We'll be back on October the 17th. Pastor Paul will be preaching for a couple of weeks while I'm gone, so no reason to stay away. He's a better preacher than I am anyway. You can support the next couple of weeks. We're doing an in-gathering of gifts. We'll gather jewelry, hats and t-shirts, which kind of have Arizona themes on them. We would like kitchen utensils, spatulas and stuff you use in the kitchen, things like that. We're going to take as much of that as we can. We'll clear out a golf bag, one of those bags that people travel with, golf bags. We'll fill that up with all that stuff, and we'll take that along with us. And we'll buy books when we get there. So if you'd like to donate money for the trip, we will make sure that we are able to buy gifts and when we arrive there in Oringa. So that's happening in just 2 weeks. So we got 2 Sundays here to do some in-gathering. I hope you'll be participate in that and then do that with us. So we're looking forward. Larissa, Marley, Mary Sue, and I are going this year. A smaller group than we've had in the past, but we're looking forward to the trip. So those are the announcements that I have for us today, the things that we're up to. Let's begin now our worship and take this time during the prelude to prepare ourselves for the time of prayer and reflection. All right, the congregation stand now as we face the baptismal font. We will do not the order for confession and forgiveness as we usually do at the beginning of our service, but an order for affirmation of baptism. This format is the format to choose when we do confirmation with young people or when a new member is joining the church. And so this is our own affirmation of vocation and our baptismal, our own baptism. So we'll follow along with that. We start with prayer together. Creator God, we praise you for the waters of baptism that draw us daily into greater relationship with you and with all that you have made. Your heart is open to us in our struggles. You listen to us in any need, and you name us as your beloved children. In your grace, open our hearts also to serve as Christ served, so that we may follow where you have led and see the face of Christ in our neighbors. Amen. Beloved children of God, in your baptism, you made public profession of your faith. Do you intend to continue in the covenant that God made with you in your holy baptism, to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God, and to share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people following the example of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth? I do, and I ask God to help and guide me. In these promises, you have committed yourself to Christian vocation, to love and to serve one another. Share in the good news that God has done for you in the word and deed, and follow Jesus' example of service. May God, who has claimed you and as beloved and a holy baptism, guide your word, your steps, and your work in the rest and your rest for all of your days. Amen. Our gathering hymn is God's Work Our Hands. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Mighty and merciful God, lover of justice and equity, you call us to support the weak, to help those who suffer, and to honor all people. By the power of your Holy Spirit, make us advocates for your justice and instruments of your peace, so that all may be reconciled in your beloved community. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. I invite the congregation to be seated for the reading of the lessons.
A reading from James, the second chapter. My brothers and sisters, do you, with your acts of favoritism, really believe in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ? For if a person with gold rings and in fine clothes comes into your assembly, and if a poor person in dirty clothes also comes in, and if you take notice of the one wearing the fine clothes and say, "Have a seat here, please," while to the other one who is poor, you say, "Stand there," or "Sit at my feet." Have you not made distinctions among yourselves and become judges with evil thoughts? Listen, my beloved brothers and sisters, has not God chosen the poor in the world to be rich in faith and to be heirs of the kingdom that he has promised to those who love him? But you have dishonored the poor. Is it not the rich who oppress you? Is it not they who drag you into court? Is it not they who blaspheme the excellent name that was invoked over you? You do well if you really fulfill the royal law according to the scripture. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. But if you show partiality, you commit sin and are convicted by the law as transgressors. For whoever keeps the whole law but fails in one point has become accountable for all of it. For the one who said, "You shall not commit adultery," also said, "You shall not murder." Now, if you do not commit adultery, but if you murder, you have become a transgressor of the law. So speak and so act as those who are to be judged by the law of liberty. For judgment will be without mercy to anyone who has shown no mercy. Mercy triumphs over judgment. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if you say you have faith but do not have works? Can faith save you? If a brother or sister is naked and lacks daily food, and one of you says to them, "Go in peace, keep warm and eat your fill," and yet you do not supply their bodily needs, what is the good of that? So faith by itself, if it has no works, is dead. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Today is Patriot Day also. I think it was George Bush first did this. Every president since then has declared that this would be, September 11th would be Patriot Day. And it's a day, it's on the website, on the president's website, listed as a day of service and remembrance. And, you know, we remember on this day, of course, the lives that were lost in that awful attack back in 2001. But, you know, there are so many lives that are lost all around the world all the time in useless things. They estimate right now that maybe more than 70,000 Ukrainians and Russians have died in this war in Europe. Perhaps 50,000 Ethiopian civilians have died in the conflicts in Ethiopia. You know, there is enough food production in the world to feed everybody on the surface of the planet. And yet, there are perhaps 800 million people who live in hunger every day. So there are things that we need to remember as we come to this place of worship today. And the way in which we are all of us called to be disciples is to live lives of service and peace. To learn to set aside all of those things which cause wars, which cause those things, grievances, prejudices, fears, entitlements, self-referentialism, self-centeredness. The things, if all of humanity were to live in service each to the other, then these things would begin to diminish. And we could live in peace. This is the call of the gospel. And so we make small measures, we try to live that way. James, the lesson which was just read from the book of James, says, faith without works is dead. Most of us think of the term faith as being a cognitive thing, right? You know, so I believe in it, right? And that's sufficient. But faith is so much more than that. Faith is about engaging with what you believe, right? Faith is about moving forward, living out what you believe. And so James, I don't know whether James was writing as a corrective to Paul or not, but you know, Paul so relies heavily on the saved by grace through faith apart from works of the law, you know, is what we as Lutherans always remember about Paul. But Paul says, will faith save you? Listen carefully to what Paul says. Paul says, saved by grace, not by faith. Saved by grace, through faith, we embrace the good news of God's love for us. And when we embrace the good news of God's love for us, we live differently. And if you go on, even in Paul, and you read verse 10, saved by grace through faith apart from works of the law, is verse 8 and 9 in Ephesians chapter 2. Verse 10 says, so that you can do the good works which were prepared before you were born. You see? So we're called to service in our lives. God's Work Our Hands Sunday has been a tradition now in the Lutheran Church for a good number of years. I think it maybe started out as an advertising byline, the marketing thing, right? You know, so, the God's Work Our Hands, ELCA, God's Work Our Hands, right? But, you know, it's so much more than that. It's really just a wonderful short summary of what it is that we are called to do as Christians, as brothers and sisters in Christ. You know, God is at work all the time. God is at work drawing people to God's self. God is at work trying to bring peace into the world. God is at work bringing food and clothing and shelter. But God does all of those things through us, through our hands and our feet and our voices. If they don't get done through us, they don't get done. So, God's Work Our Hands Sunday is really a great summary. And CTL has long had a history of being involved in community service. And it's really quite surprising. I don't know if you ever get to the last page of the announcements that come out on Wednesday, but if you ever get to the last page, there's a box at the top and it lists some of our partners. Foothills Caring Corps, Foothills Food Bank, Neighbors in Need Arizona, which is a ministry to help folks who are homeless and need care and allow the churches to support them. Spirit in the Desert Retreat Center. Grace Lutheran Church, whose byline for them is In the City for Good, which has got that double meaning, which is fantastic, right? The Shoebox Ministries, the chaplaincy for the homeless. We have given $30,000 last year in scholarships to support indigenous and minority seminary education so that there can be pastors who serve those communities. Lutheran Social Services of the Southwest, the Navajo Evangelical Lutheran Mission, Grand Canyon Synod of the ELCA, ELCA Disaster Relief, ELCA World Hunger, Vega Qua Vega, which is the partnership with the St. Paul Area Synod and the churches in the Iringa Diocese of the Tanzania Lutheran Church, and our particular parish partner is in Denzabili, and we have done projects, prayers, service, we've done scholarships, done through St. Paul Partners, another group, we have drug wells, we have supported the Watoto ministers. And then our legacy fund, which is an endowment fund, in turn has also expanded our mission to support the Bridge for Hope, the Bridge to Hope, Dignity for Daughters in the Iringa Diocese, Mashabora, an empowerment training in Kenya, Cheers Recovery, mental health, substance abuse and recovery support, and Trevor's Vision. You know, we are out there, and I congratulate you as a congregation, but we're never out there enough. There's always more to be done. And so today, we're going to take this time, Lorraine's going to come up, she's going to tell us how this project's going to work, and we're going to get this, going to knock this out for the next 15 minutes, right? So bang, bang, bang. So Lorraine, talk to us.
Yeah, you hope.
Yeah, you hope.
First off, I asked all of you to catch black people with my left arm, right arm, and right hand. With this, Janine, you have on try to pack everything for us already. And John Cornell is probably watching on to without the whole of these boxes and stuff. And we create shells for the gift of Christmas to get everything. I am so grateful that we managed probably to get 200 of everything. So well done.
It says mail, seven
mail.
Items. So Get to work. Everybody up. Everybody start. Yeah, question. Finished flowers go right up there by the altar. Thank you. The women start there. Men start back here. Women can help the men since there are more women here than men. But had for a while during COVID. We're back to it now. Yeah. Yep. Into the prayer there, a prayer blessing for all of these items that are going out, and then we'll continue with the prayers and intercession on the next page. The litany on page 5. Only a life lived in service to others is worth living. Let me be as Christ. If you can't feed 100 people, then feed just one. Let me be as Christ. If you find it in your heart to care for somebody else, you will have succeeded. Let me be as Christ, who helps in saving others, saves himself as well. Let me be in Christ. Generous God, we thank you for your openness to our needs and your abundance in blessing us with these gifts. Receive these supplies that we may glorify you and sustain our neighbors in need. Bless these gifts, that our hands and our hearts to your service. Amen. Invite the congregation to stand now as we join in the prayers of intercession on page 6. Trusting God at work in and among us, we raise our hearts and our voices in prayer for the needs of the world. For your work, in the church we give thanks. Plant and tend relationships among faith communities, that in faithful listening, speech, and actions, our hands' work do bear fruit for the sake of all in need. God of grace, we pray, hear us when we call. For your work in creation, we give thanks. Sustain peoples and places affected by climate change, ecological devastation, and natural disasters. Prosper the work of creation care ministries locally and globally, that with our minds and hearts open and our hands work to lovingly care for the earth. God of life, we pray. Hear us when we call. For your work among the nations, we give thanks. Direct leaders in paths of honest service, that both their words and actions are carried out on behalf of those whom they serve. God of righteousness, we pray. Hear us when we call. For your work in places of need, we give thanks. Sustain all who are wearied by unemployment or lack of adequate food or housing, that we might advocate for relief and just policy. Bring healers to all who are sick, through the skillful hands and compassionate hearts of physicians, nurses, therapists, and caregivers. We pray, Lord, for those in our midst in need of your care. We pray for Dave, Bill and Patty, Jack, Jenny, Bill, Tiffany, Kate, Ken, Jim, Sam, Linda, Erica, Chuck, Tony, Susie, Jerry and Pat, Larry and Joyce, Roger, and those, Lord, whom we name before you now. God of restoration, we pray. Hear us when we call. For your work in our neighborhoods, towns, and cities, we give thanks. Guide our common life together so that children, youth, and adults of all ages flourish. Teach us to listen attentively to our neighbors. And any new endeavors, consider those who may be left out or underserved. God of wisdom, we pray. For your work in this worshiping community, we give thanks. Bless the service projects of this day and throughout the year. Foster deeper connections among those who serve and a spirit of accompaniment as we work alongside those in our community. Strengthen our faith that we trust God moving in and among us. God of love, we pray. Hear us when we call. For your work among those who came before us, we give thanks. We remember those who have died and who are held forever in your loving hands. Especially those today, we remember Dennis and Kathy, Rod, and those in our midst whom we have lost. Hold us in your presence now and always. God of heaven and earth, hear us when we call. Receive these and all our prayers, gracious God. We pray in the name of Jesus and by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Invite the congregation to be seated that we may gather the offering. Let be fruitful, Lord, and fill the brim of blessing. Gather up harvest from the seas that were sown, that we may be fed with the bread of life. Gather up and the trees of the wall, unite them in the prayers we offer. Grace our table with presents, and give us a foretaste of the Let us pray. Gracious God, in your great love, you richly provide for our needs. Make of these gifts a banquet of blessing, and make us ready to share with all in need. Through Jesus Christ, who sets a table for all. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior, Jesus Christ, who on this day, and the night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup. When he had given thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink of this cup, we remember the Lord's death until he comes again. Now let us pray together in the words which our Lord taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Invite the congregation to be seated. In this bread, this wine, this body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, we're joined to one another. We're joined to the people who have gone before us for centuries, the people who are yet to come, the people who are now all over the world this day celebrating this supper together. We're joined to all of those people, all of those hands together can do great work in the world. So if this meal is for all God's people. If you're here this day, you are welcome at this table. Come, feast on the Lord. We stand. Now may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen us and keep us in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. God of abundant table, you have refreshed our hearts in this meal with bread for the journey. Give us your grace on the road that we might serve our neighbors with joy. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Thank you. Almighty God, by the power of the Spirit, you have knit us as your servants into one body of your Son, Jesus Christ. Look with favor upon us in our commitment to serve in Christ's name. Give us courage, patience, and vision, and strengthen us all in our Christian vocation of witness to the world and service to others through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Go in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.